criticism of the marching bands at Trooping for the Colour to the haunting strains of the solo bugle playing The Last Post. The soundtrack to Britain's military history is known the world over.
For more than 160 years, the Army's musicians have trained in Twickenham, but all that is set to change, as Breakfast's Tim Muffet has been finding out.
Since 1857, more than 20,000 army musicians have trained here.
I think people just think musicians turn up and they play, and it's somehow morphed into their psyche. They don't realise all the preparation that goes behind the scenes.
The Ministry of Defence has announced that by 2020, Kneller Hall in southwest London will be sold as part of a wider property review. The Royal Military School of Music will continue, but it doesn't know where. It won't be on this site.
We need to record the history of the actual people who were involved at Kneller Hall.
So a huge archive project has begun. Interviews with veterans are being recorded.
It was a wonderful experience.
More veterans are being urged to get in touch and take part.
Okay, my name is Stuart Marsh.
And this is a kind of a line in the sand moment. I think it's a great opportunity to capture all this information. It's a combination of the music, the uniforms, and it's something that we do that nobody else around the globe can even compete with.
The Royal Military School of Music owes its existence to an embarrassing incident involving Queen Victoria.
Different army bands have been brought together to perform the national anthem in honour of Queen Victoria's birthday. But each regiment had a different conductor and played a different arrangement. The result was a complete unharmonious mess, and the Queen was not amused.
So a centre of excellence was established. Musicians now perform at more than 3,000 events a year. The next big one is the wedding of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle. The archive team are also recording different types of military music. It was once a key way of communicating.
So which was that bugle call then?
So that was a charge call.
So that means dinner's ready.
That means dinner's ready. Scoffs up, it's time to eat.
The hope is older veterans will come forward and perform the music they remember.
The bugle calls, there's over 100 of them. How many of those are actually known now by military soldiers? So, you know, it's essential that we capture that. Even as recently as the 1950s, bugle calls were being used on the battlefield in the Korean War.
What's the most difficult one to play?
It's perhaps not technically challenging, but The Last Post, I think, because of the sense of history, gravitas, and importance that's attached to it.
One chapter of military history is about to end. Kneller Hall will be gone, but not forgotten. Tim Muffet, BBC News.
I love that.
Lovely, isn't it?
Just perfect, isn't it? The noise. It's not a noise, though, is it?
No.
No, it's not the best way.
It's music.
You know what I mean? It's music, but it's haunting and it's sort of gets you in the right mood for everything, isn't it? I like it. Anyway, I'm not describing it very well, but it's good.